Mr. Ramon Jauregui, President of the EUROLAT Parliamentary Commission, representing Mr. Martin Schulz, the European Parliament President. Mr. Minister Ramirez, representing the CELAC Presidency, Excellences Ambassadors and members of the Diplomatic Services, Mr. Koen de Vlaeck, representing the Flemish Government, dear colleagues, rectors, and members of the academic communities, ladies and gentlemen. It is for all of you, as for me, a genuine surprise to welcome in Brussels the EU Latin American Caribbean Academic Summit at the ESHEC Brussels Management School for its opening session. Given the security problems at the European Parliament, our former international economics professor and president of the local organizing committee, Professor Christian Limers, asked us to manage the crisis, and as an efficient management school, we arranged the venue but could not finalize the renovation of all the premises, as producing miracles is not within our mission. Nevertheless, the most important thing is that we met the challenge. We are here together for opening the second summit, and welcome to you all. As ESHEC is actually known as the Brussels Management School, we have been very active for the past 40 years in implementing a true strategic international relationship with Latin America. Not only we have been sending students to Latin America for their practical thesis projects, but we have developed an exchange student program with 12 countries of the region, but also an academic cooperation program with Mexican, Peruvian, Paraguayan, Chilean, Colombian, and Brazilian institutions. Further, in our school, we have more than 20% of foreign students in our undergraduate and graduate programs. Our executive development program is the largest in Belgium. We develop joint programs for executive for US university, as well as Tunisian, Algerian, Moroccan institution, as French business schools. In the field of international networking, we are also proud to be a member of CLADEA, but also as IPAS certified institution and AACSB member, we are in the forefront of international academic networking. Lastly but not least, ESHEC is hosting IRELAC, the main sponsor of this academic summit, within its premises in the Manoir d'Anjou campus, the second campus. In other words, you should know that being here, you are in your own house. And if you want to actively cooperate with our institution, you could contact the Vice Dean Sophie Peters, who will be open for discussions and cooperation. Although it's not my task today to enter into the debate, I cannot resist sharing with you my deep conviction that the academic summit, as a genuine and open bottom-up movement, is crucial for the common interest and future of the Europe and the CELAC region. The strategic alliance our politic leaders wanted to launch in Rio de Janeiro 16 years ago needs also our voice. I mean our intensified academic cooperation between both regions is an essential component of such an alliance. We all know the triple helix of innovation: government, business, and university are the three complementary partners for putting in motion the innovation and knowledge society we very much need for being able to meet the global challenges we face anyway together and with similar social options. Climatic changes, aging, social cohesion, and equity gender inequality, productivity stagnation, violence, terrorism. These dynamics could be accelerated by direct EU-CELAC cooperation, innovation needs differences, but similar prospects and shared values. Our two regions offer precisely this combination, freeing the highest potential opportunities. I see a fantastic field for attractive complementarities between our heterogeneous societies that an intensified bioregional cooperation between our universities could open. This could make possible to improve together our insertion in the global value chains, not just because, and it's crucial, we could improve our respective productivities and technological innovation, but also for improving social cohesion and turning our social models in a component of economic success and sustainability. Indeed, social cohesion and justice in turn generates spillovers on citizen participation and democratic governance, feeding back sustainable socio-economic development. Our shared rules and values allow for generating faster catalyst effects than with any other region, able to trigger a new dynamics for closing the excessive remaining gaps between business, universities, and policies. At the first academic summit in Santiago de Chile in January 2013, claimed rightly, our academic cooperation constitutes an essential pillar of a bi-regional strategic alliance between the EU and the CELAC, and we should promote such fundamental objectives. This allows me to conclude my brief introduction by addressing to all of you a key question that the manager of a business school I am has in mind. How to reach between EU and CELAC members not just a freer market, but also a fairer market. Academic communities should try to build together an answer. Thank you.